Manny calls Lola.
Why wasn't she there to pick him up?
Manny picked up the diamonds. Dropped them off.
Drugs?
Got paid. Everything went fine. Except for one thing. Lola wasn't there to pick him up.
Except for one thing.
Her moped was stolen.
Lola wasn't
Manny
there to
had to
pick
take
him up.
The train. There was a bum who fell over. Then the train inspector got on. He got off.
There was a bum who fell over. Then the train inspectors got on.
There was a bum who got off.
The bag stayed.
The bag stayed.
The bum gets the bag.
The bum gets the bag.
How much was in the bag? 100,000 Deutschmarks.
100,000 Deutschmarks.
How much was in the bag?
Manny needs 100,000 in 20 minutes.
At 12,
by the watertower. 20 minutes, or Ronnie will kill him.
20
minutes. What will Manny do? Rob the supermarket if Lola isn't there.
What will Manny do?
20 minutes.
In time.
What will Lola do? Run.
What will Lola do?
Run.
Who will she go to? Her father. Lola runs and runs. Through the streets and under bridges, she runs and runs and runs. As she continues along the street, a cyclist calls out to her and they share a brief conversation. But Lola keeps running. She speeds past the car of her father's co-worker, and he stops abruptly, only to crash into another car driven by thugs. Lola doesn't care for it. She continues to run to her father, passing the bum with Manny's money. As she enters her father's office, she interrupts him and his mistress, and he shuns her and forces her out. She's not his daughter, he says. He will not help. As she stands outside, she asks an old woman for the time. Less than 5 minutes left. She has to run again, this time to Manny. But she's too late. He's robbing the supermarket. She helps and they get the 100,000 marks. But upon fleeing, they are surrounded by police. Surrendering, Manny throws the money bag into the air, startling a police officer who shoots Lola in the chest. Lola falls.
I wish I was a stranger who understands.
And starts to fade.
I wish I was a starship with silence flying by. I wish I was a princess with armies at her hand.
Take two. Lola leaves the apartment and once again scales Berlin in search of the 100,000. She again meets the cyclist from the first timeline and runs past her mayor, again causing him to crash. Same again. She bumps into the bum, but how could she have known that he'd have Manny's cash? She keeps going and runs to the bank, where the security guard lets her into her dad's office, but the same disaster strikes. Her dad refuses to help. Lola knows it's life or death, so this time she steals the security guard's gun, takes everyone inside hostage, and obtains the cash by force. She's unfazed. It looks like she's going to get away with it, until the police arrive to arrest her. As Lola leaves the bank, she's totally surrounded, but somehow slips away. The old woman from the first sequence once again tells her the time. Unsurprisingly, she's running out of it. Lola runs to the crossroads, where Manny has been waiting for her. Time's up. She's got the money, but an ending equally as abrupt as the first. Manny's saved from death at the hands of his mobster boss by an ambulance that hits and kills him as he crosses the bridge.
Restart. One last chance. Lola runs again. She meets the cyclist from the previous sequences, and the camera breaks off to follow him until he arrives at a food stand where we see none other than the bum who's got Manny's money. Meanwhile, Lola runs in front of her mayor's car, preventing the crash that occurred earlier in the film. A split screen reveals where she's going, back to the bank. Whilst Lola sprints to meet her dad, he's shown leaving work to meet her mayor. The two men drive off before Lola can catch them. It's time to change the plan. In the meantime, Manny, miraculously prompted by a blind woman, spots the bum who took his money and chases after him. Coincidentally, her Maya and Lola's dad are driving behind them. A catastrophic car crash sees Manny and the bum escape unscathed, whilst Lola's dad, her Maya, and the man who stole Lola's moped at the start are all gravely injured. Lola's still running. She narrowly avoids getting hit by a truck, then enters a casino and buys all the chips she can. She makes her first win and bets all of it on her lucky number, 20. A miracle. She wins again. Lola takes her cash and leaves. Meanwhile, Manny threatens to shoot the bum in order to get his money back. He's got it. He gives the bum his gun and continues running. Lola arrives at the crossroads. The money's in the bag. Manny arrives in his boss's car. He's congratulated, and Lola knows everything's okay. Manny walks towards her, carefree, whilst Lola's face suggests she hasn't forgotten the trauma of all three sequences. Nevertheless, they set off together, hand in hand, as Manny asks casually what's in Lola's bag.